Sometimes you can see world-changing events coming, but then there are the accidents, unforeseen moments that alter the course of nations for generations to come. Take the spark that began the First World War. Most know that that spark was the assassination of Archduke Franz Ferdinand, the heir to the Austro-Hungarian Empire. But his assassin was only successful because of a single wrong turn taken by Ferdinand's driver. As many historians, including recently Christopher Clark, have written, Ferdinand was on a motorcade through Sarajevo with little concern for ethnic Serb resentment of the empire's 1908 annexation of Bosnia-Herzegovina. The motorcade, having run into Serbian terrorists, had decided to take an alternate route. But no one translated the instructions to Ferdinand's Czech driver, who turned onto Franz Josef Street, the old route. The driver was alerted of his mistake. The car stopped right in front of a general store, and standing in wait under the awning, armed with a revolver, was Gavrilo Princip, a 19-year-old Bosnian Serb. The rest, Europe's call to arms, the loss of millions of lives in World War I, the devastation of whole nations, is tragedy. But small slips don't always have big consequences immediately. Take Spain, which is currently in the midst of its worst political crisis in decades.
Buenos dias.
Prime Minister Pedro Sanchez, after losing the support of Catalan politicians, was forced to dissolve parliament and call a snap election that Spaniards are voting in this weekend.
He propuesto la disolución de las cámaras.
As the New York Times lays out in a recent story, this can all be traced back to the decision more than 40 years ago to omit a single word from the new post-Franco democratic constitution. Catalan politicians wanted their own territory and others like it, places with distinct languages and cultures, to be described as nations. In the end, in a compromise, everyone agreed to describe them instead as nationalities, granting them a degree of autonomy. Then in 2010, a high court ruled that certain sought-after administrative reforms were impossible because Catalonia was not designated a nation. That sparked a rage in Catalonia and moved politicians towards separatist demands that had previously been a fringe pursuit. The extended stalemate ever since has toppled two governments, reignited the long-dormant fire of the far right, and threatened 40 years of relative democratic harmony in Spain. Or consider the border between the Republic of Ireland and Northern Ireland, forged in 1921. For the British, once they decided to grant Ireland de facto independence, the border itself seemed almost an afterthought. The historian Diarmaid Ferriter, author of the new book, The Border, said that the Irish question was considered an irritant after the First World War, at a time when Britain was far more focused on alliances with the US and France. When the line was drawn through homes and scores of country roads, Prime Minister David Lloyd George was satisfied that they had got rid of the Irish question. But that badly drawn border fueled decades of insurgency and violence between the two Irelands. And today, as Pankaj Mishra noted in the New York Times, it has ironically become the biggest threat to an orderly Brexit. That's because, as Brexiteers seem to forget when clamoring for the exit in 2016, it is now the only land border between the European Union and the United Kingdom. A genuine Brexit would seem to require a new hard border between Europe and Britain, two distinct entities. But peace between the north and south of Ireland depend on that being an open border. This tension could cost Theresa May her prime ministership, Ireland its uneasy peace, and Britain its territorial integrity. One of the biases of hindsight is to see the events of history as inevitable, the product of great forces and great figures moving surely toward an immutable goal. But sometimes the fate of nations hinges on a wrong turn, a single word, or even a hastily drawn line.